So, I got a new alarm on the Corolla. I took out the Excalibur. No. It's a 1670. Brain and everything. It's quite big. So, those are in there. And I actually went with Scytek. And it comes with this two-way remote. But, that piece right there came off and I'm not able to put the battery in, so hopefully I get a replacement under warranty. I never used it, or I just get a new one. Here's the box. Scytek A4.2W two-way. So that one's supposed to be working, but like I said, inside it's not. One of the wire metal piece came out. So this one's a little different. So you just hold it to, of course, you got unlock, then lock. Now, remote start, you have to hold this for 2 seconds. Enough. Horn, these three, four times? Excuse the dirtiness. And of course, it's like any other one. Any other remote start, and of course, you unlock it. This car is dirty, whatever. And you'll put the key to the start, the start position. Press on the brake, and you go on your route today. Simple enough. Peace. So we got the Astro Scytek A4.2W. It's a two-way remote start alarm. Entry. So there's two remotes. Pretty small package. Let's see. Oh, that's the valet switch antenna. Shock sensor, horn, sorry, foot pin, connection for the shock sensor. There's the brain, pretty small, huh? Of course, then there's the ports. And here is the two-way remote. We'll get to in a sec. And all the wiring. And instruction books. So let's get to this two-way remote. Try to open with one hand, but we'll see what we can do. And there it is. So I'll plug the battery in and rebuild it. So AAA. So you're probably wondering after the remote started, if someone gets in there, can they go in and drive off? Turn off the horn. It only goes off when the alarm goes off. So it only goes off when the alarm goes off. So someone goes in there when the car started. So we'll unlock it. And when the door opens, it's gonna fire off the alarm and it's gonna shut off the engine. So no one can take it. And I got it washed. Thank goodness for Costco. So, So if anyone of the doors open, or the hood, or the trunk, it'll fire off. And the siren and the horn. So here's the two remote. There's the lock and lock button. Function, trunk, and parent system. So, icon. And it has two-way visual, two-way pager, notification. And there's the signal. I guess so. Means there isn't any range. And we hit that for 10 minutes. But if you go to this other room, you should be able to reach because it's one of the fifth floor. Okay, so here's the remote. So I hit unlock, flashes green. See? Then I hit the lock. Right. Flashes green. Now if I want to start it, wait for 2 seconds. Green. Scared the shit of someone. Yeah, see the car light up. And the fog lights turn on. Letting you know that it was started, and hit the remote again. Hit this button here, and it'll turn it off.
makes this weird sound, but
pretty good range.
All right, there's the two-way, finally at home, of course. Lock. And remote start. Set for 15 minutes. And if you decide not to go anywhere, you can just hit that again. Funny. So I updated the feature on the alarm because I noticed a couple times when I leave or get home, I forget to arm the car. So it ought to have it set to where as soon as you close the door, about 3 seconds or so, it'll arm the vehicle and lock the doors. Then you hear a confirmation chirp and the lights will flash once and arm the vehicle. And there's someone coming. Oh, there you go. I should be armed.